Something. Please listen to me.
What now, Jeff Star? Are you going to tell us about yourself again?
Yes, Mr. Juice. I love telling it to you guys.
You've already told us 10 million times.
10,999,999 times to be exact.
Please, I just want to tell you guys again.
Okay, Jeff Star. Go for it. Make it 11 million times.
Jeff Star. I emit blue white light, so that means I am very hot. I am very small in size, I have less luminosity, and I am very dense. I am composed of electron degenerate matters. Other than a star, my cousin red dwarf is low mass main sequence star. My cousin CMO dwarf is main sequence star with masses comparable to that of the sun. My cousin's orange dwarf is a K-type main sequence star. Blue dwarf is a barren dwarf star. Black dwarf is a white dwarf that can no longer emit light.
Haha, that's nothing compared to mine.
I'm Aldebaran. I'm a red star that is the eye of the blue and the 13th brightest in the nighttime sky. I'm a red giant, a large red star at least 10 times the diameter of the sun.
Giant stars are known for having a rather large radius for its mass and temperature. Due to the fact that the radiating area is huge, the brightness of these stars are very huge.
I don't think so, Aldebaran. I think I'm the largest among three of us. Betelgeuse. It's pronounced as Betelgeuse.
I am a red supergiant star, and the largest of all stars, and 100 times more luminous. I explode as supernova, and I can form black holes. Although my mass is just 15 to 25 times that of the sun, the star is currently about 860 million miles, or 1.4 billion kilometers across, or 1,000 times wider than Earth's stars.
Not so fast, Betelgeuse. I'm also above the main sequence.
I'm 100 times more luminous though.
Stop fighting, Betelgeuse and Aldebaran.
Who's that?
Is that you, dwarf?
No.
Hey, I'm Sun, and I'm a main sequence star. And I'm the closest main sequence star to the Earth. I'm a yellow dwarf. I am about halfway through my main sequence of about 10 billion years.